yeah.
Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. We are nearing the end of this FCS spring regular season, which means that some of these conference races, guys, are really starting to heat up. Some of these conference races are getting really tight down the stretch. Some of them, of course, going to determine if a team gets into the FCS playoffs or not. Remember, the FCS playoffs will consist of 16 teams here in just a few weeks. But we have a very tight conference race in our first game of the week, and it is between number 7, Kennesaw State, the Owls, traveling on the road to take on the 20th-ranked Monmouth Hawks. The Owls versus the Hawks, and it's going to be a really great matchup in the Big South. Both of these teams are unbeaten in conference play. The winner, of course, will take full control of the Big South and will put themselves in a very good position heading into the playoffs again just in a few weeks. So we're here to break down everything you need to know between this battle between the Owls and the Hawks. Do we have Kennesaw State, a top 10 team now? Do we have them going on the road pulling off this win? Or do we have Monmouth, who's only played 2 games so far this year? Do we have them pulling off a monumental upset? So let's take a look at the background for both these teams where we really break down the stats, the offense, the defense, everything like that. When you look at Kennesaw State, they are a top 10 team. Again, 7th in the country. You don't get there just by being a fluke. You don't get there just because of your name. But a lot of people think that the Owls are very overrated. A lot of people aren't giving the Owls a whole lot of credit. They're just 4-0, 2-0 in the conference. Very, very weak strength of schedule. And I think that's why so many people aren't buying the Owls right now, as their strength of schedule has been very weak. Outside of their one win over Shorter College, it's bad enough as it is, their combined record, the combined record of all the other opponents they've defeated is 2-7. They beat Charleston Southern, Dixie State, and Robert Morris last week, defeated them 35-0. 2-7 is the combined record of these other three opponents outside of Shorter College. So Kennesaw State really hasn't played anybody that difficult. I would say Monmouth is definitely going to be the toughest game for them so far this season. But when you look at the Hawks, on the other hand, they've only played 2 games so far in this spring season. They did play Charleston Southern, beat them by 18. They defeated Gardner-Webb 48-19 last week. So they've looked good in the 2 games that they've played, but with a lack of experience. You know, they've played 2 less games than Kennesaw State. Again, neither of those 2 games against very high-quality opponents. Will that come back to bite them, despite this game being at home? So let's take a look at the offenses first. I want to start with the Owls. We always start with that road team. So let's start with Kennesaw State and look. If you love the triple option, you better watch this game because the Owls run a prolific triple option offensive attack. So if you love Army, Navy, Air Force, guys like that at the FBS level, this game is going to be for you because you're going to get to see that triple option back in action. So make sure to keep an eye on that. But you look at the Owls, guys, it's unreal to me when I talk about the triple option, the limited amount of passes these teams attempt. The Kennesaw State Owls have attempted 17 passes all year long. That's it. 4 games, they've attempted 17 passes. They're averaging just 69.8 passing yards per game. They don't have to throw the ball when they're averaging 296 rushing yards per game, guys. They're averaging 296 rushing yards per game. They've eclipsed 225 rushing yards in every game they've played this year. They've eclipsed 300 yards in 3 of the 4 games they've played this year. That's unreal. It's unheard of. But again, that's kind of what you expect when that's all you do on offense, when all you do is run the ball. When you look at the playmakers for Kennesaw State, who's making these plays, racking up the yards? They've got so many guys that can do it. They've got Kyle Glover, the running back, has 278 yards, 2 touchdowns on the year. They have Isaac Foster, another running back, has 189 yards, is averaging 7.9 yards per carry. And then they've got a plethora of quarterbacks that they're going through. They've got Tommy Bryant, Jonathan Murphy. Yes, they're contributing a little bit through the air, but they are running the triple option very effectively as well. This entire offense is made of playmakers for the Owls. They're so, so difficult to stop. And I don't even know if Monmouth will be able to do that on Saturday because you know exactly what they're going to do. Guys that play Navy, Army, guys like that, you know what they're going to do. They're going to run the ball, and yet they still can't stop it. You look at Monmouth. What's their offense going to look like? Having only played 2 games, it's kind of difficult to figure that out. It's kind of difficult to say, well, if you look at the average numbers here, because they played two games. We haven't really seen them in action that much. So you don't really know what you're going to get. But what we have seen through two games is a very balanced offensive attack. The Hawks have been prolific on both sides. Charleston Southern, they threw for 297 yards, rushed for 175. Then when they played Gardner-Webb, again defeating them 48-19, they had 155 passing yards and 252 rushing yards. So they have had one game where they've been prolific through the air and pretty good on the ground, and then the exact opposite, prolific on the ground and mediocre decent through the air. They can do it all. They can do it on both sides. It's a balanced offense here for the Hawks. And their biggest playmaker, guys, is not a quarterback, it's not a running back, but it's their wide receiver. And, you know, usually we focus so much on quarterbacks, stuff like that, but it's their wide receiver here, guys. Terrence Green Jr. has 9 receptions for 212 yards and 2 touchdowns in just 2 games this year. He has accounted for 46.9% of the Hawks' reception yards this year. Almost half of the team's reception yards have been accrued, have been just totaled up by Terrence Green Jr. That's unreal. He has a chance maybe he can get to 50% if he has another big game against Kennesaw State. One last thing I will say about Monmouth here, guys, is they are a fast offensive team in addition to being balanced. Again, it's only been 2 games, but they have scored 12 offensive touchdowns so far this season. So they've had 12 touchdown drives on offense. Only 2 of those 12 drives have lasted longer than 3 minutes. Think about that. 2 of the 12 offensive touchdown drives have lasted longer than 3 minutes. Everything else has been less than that. That's insanely impressive. They rely on that home run ball. They play a fast style of ball on offense, and they absolutely can wear you down. They like those speedsters, Terrence Green Jr., the speedsters, the home run ball, the ability to go no huddle and play fast. It's enough to wear down a defense. And you can't help but wonder if Kennesaw State will get run down on Saturday. Can't help but wonder that. Because, like we mentioned earlier, Monmouth is going to be the best team that the Owls have faced, in my opinion, all year long. All year long. Probably the best offense they have certainly faced, too. So you look at Kennesaw State's defense here. They've been strong, but how much stock can you put into that because of their weak strength of schedule? They've allowed just 12.3 points per game. They've allowed 137.5 passing yards per game. They've allowed 95.8 rushing yards per game. Those numbers, every single one of them, ridiculous, fantastic. You play a 8-game season, 9-game season, and you have those numbers, you probably are the best defense in the country. But Kennesaw State's played 4 games against weak opponents. How much stock can you put into that? So these are amazing numbers just against relatively weak opponents. Will Monmouth be able to exploit them? Is Kennesaw State, period, going to be exploited on Saturday? They got a lot of doubters out there. They need to silence those doubters. Can they do it? When you look at the Hawks and their defense, I kind of ask the same question. How much stock can you put into it? They've played 2 games against, again, relatively weak opponents. But the biggest number you need to watch out for Monmouth is their rushing defense, obviously. If you're going up against a team that's going to run the triple option and runs it so well, so effectively, your rushing defense is going to be the key, because Kennesaw State is not going to line up in shotgun and start chunking it through the air, you know, 5-6 times on a drive. It's just not going to happen. That's not what they do. That's not their style. So Monmouth has to be able to shut down the run. And when you've looked at their rushing numbers in the last 2 games, they allowed 28 rushing yards in their first game to Charleston Southern. They allowed 94 rushing yards to Gardner-Webb. They allowed just 2.7 yards per carry against Gardner-Webb. So they have allowed a total of 122 rushing yards on the year, 61 per game on average. Again, just 2 games though. But while that sounds great, while they only allowed 1 yard per carry against Charleston Southern and 2.7 yards per carry against Gardner-Webb, they haven't seen a team like Kennesaw State. They have not seen a team that's so dominant up front, so fast in the backfield, has quarterbacks and running backs and receivers that can do so much damage on the ground. They haven't seen that. Are they going to be ready for it? And my last key I will say for Monmouth before we give you our official prediction here for this Big South game is not only do they have to stop the run, but they have to get quick defensive stops. Because Kennesaw State, with that triple option, the same again can be said for those military academies, they rely on the time of possession. They dominate the time of possession. So it's kind of a two-sided key here, I think, for Monmouth here is first off, get quick defensive stops. Because if you allow Kennesaw State to go on a 7-8 minute long drive and get points out of it, your defense is going to get worn down. Your defense is going to get worn down, especially if your offense doesn't generate anything. So they have to get quick defensive stops. Their defense has to get run down. And on the offensive side of the ball, they have to make every possession count. Because with Kennesaw State, how well they dominate, holding the ball for 40 minutes, 45 minutes, however long it may be, the offense for Monmouth might not have many chances to go put points on the board. So every offensive possession has to count for the Hawks. Can they do it? The key to the game for them is stopping the run, and to me, making sure that Kennesaw State does not hold the ball for more than 35 minutes. They can allow them to hold it for a little over half the game. But 35 minutes, to me, is the key number when it comes to time of possession for the Hawks. They allow Kennesaw State to exceed 35 minutes with the ball, they're not going to be able to do it. I don't think they're going to be able to get the job done. That's the key. That is the key. So what is the final prediction here? We talk so much about the keys for Monmouth. Doesn't mean that we don't think they're going to happen. Doesn't mean that, I mean, we don't, what do we know, right? What do we know? This game for me has been so hard to pick, really, because I've looked at both teams. I've watched both teams. And again, like we've said so many times throughout this video, it's hard to gauge. You're looking at a very good Owls team, not taking anything away from them, that it really has played nobody. You're looking at a Monmouth team that also has played nobody, but has only played two games. So it's a matter of Kennesaw State playing more games with no quality, and Monmouth also really not playing much quality and playing less games. Now I look at this game, guys, on Saturday. Yes, a top 20 matchup. You need to keep your eye on it because anything can happen. But I think the Owls go on the road and win this game convincingly. I think Kennesaw State goes on the road and wins this game convincingly. I think they silence the doubters. They were kind of slighted by the committee just recently. A lot of fans out there don't believe they have what it takes to maybe go win a championship or make a deep playoff run. They feel like they're getting disrespected. It's not their fault that the strength of schedule is weak. They're taking care of business as a good team should. And I think against a top 20 team, again, the toughest test they've faced all year, they rise to the occasion. They go on the road and convincingly defeat the Monmouth Hawks. In doing so, they will win the Big South, and they'll be poised for a potential deep playoff run when the playoffs begin here in just a few weeks. So guys, thank you so much for watching us here at the Gridiron Expert on YouTube. Make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, share our videos. Share our videos. Help spread the word of college football and spread the word of our Gridiron Expert channel. You can also do that by listening and sharing our brand new podcast, the Gridiron Expert Podcast, on all of your streaming platforms. The links for all those things down in the description below, so make sure to go give that a look. And once again, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on the Gridiron Expert.